right now at 10.
Today, three members of our team made the ultimate sacrifice.
Two Burnsville police officers and a fire department medic shot and killed in the line of duty.
We're hurting.
By a gunman heavily armed and barricaded in a home along with seven children.
Yeah, and they had us, like a tactical or a SWAT team, come in and break out the window. And
tonight, in-depth coverage of what happened.
There is an officer who is in the hospital.
As the community comes together to honor the fallen first responders.
At times like this, we oftentimes do not have words, but we have the love that is in our hearts.
They've paid the ultimate sacrifice for all of us.
The news starts now.
Thanks for joining us tonight. Hundreds of people showed up tonight in Burnsville to honor three first responders shot and killed in the line of duty this morning. Officers Paul Elmstrand and Matthew Ruge were just 27 years old. 40-year-old Adam Finseth was a firefighter and paramedic who was part of the SWAT team responding to a domestic violence call this morning at a home in Burnsville, where officers saw a heavily armed suspect was barricaded inside with a family, including seven children. We have team coverage, including what we're learning about the fallen first responders. We begin, though, with Danny Spiewak and details on that deadly shootout. Danny?
Well, Julie, this situation unfolded overnight when Burnsville police responded to a domestic call in a residential neighborhood. During a standoff for the next several hours, police say the shooter killed three first responders before the suspect was later found dead himself.
45 Sam 48, where would you like them to stage at?
Just before 2 a.m. Sunday, Burnsville police say they responded to a domestic call where an armed suspect had barricaded himself in a home with family, including seven kids ages 2 to 15.
Yeah, it took a long time.
Neighbors watched the standoff anxiously.
Now they're all screaming, all the stuff, and then all the swollen little shots.
According to police radio audio obtained by Care 11 from Broadcastify,
shots fired.
Officers were first reported down around 5:30 a.m.
Officers inside, fall back.
Outside the home, an armored vehicle had visible bullet holes in the front windshield.
This individual had several guns and large amounts of ammunition and shot at the police officers from multiple positions within the home.
The city of Burnsville confirms the shooter killed three first responders. Two were Burnsville police officers, both 27 years old, Paul Elmstrand and Matthew Ruge.
We are all hurting.
The third person killed was 40-year-old Burnsville firefighter paramedic Adam Finseth, who is part of the SWAT team responding to the standoff.
It's a tragic day. We're all grieving, and we're all trying to understand what happened.
Police say a fourth first responder, Sergeant Adam Medlicott, was injured but is expected to survive.
Keep these families in your prayers.
Governor Walz has ordered flags to fly at half staff to honor the lives lost and all first responders.
And they go out and do the job to provide us safety that we have the luxury of not having to think about many times. And then this can happen.
Police have not identified the shooter, but they did confirm today that he is dead. They haven't said whether he killed himself or died in the exchange of gunfire. Meanwhile, they say all the family members and kids inside the home today got out safely. Back to you, Julie.
All right. Thank you, Danny. Emotional tributes to the first responders have been pouring in all day across social media. And tonight, the city of Burnsville gathered to grieve together. Morgan Wolf is live at City Hall, where hundreds of people came together for a candlelight vigil. Morgan?
Yeah, Julie, this vigil ended roughly 2 hours ago, but since then I have seen several groups of EMS workers and police officers stopping by at the memorial, really showing that heartbreak is being felt across the state.
It's our community. I've lived here 20 years.
A somber symbol.
It's sad. I didn't even know him, but it's just sad.
Is the same one used to signal support.
I have my flags on the back. I gotta show the officers I'm here for them.
Sympathies for the fallen officers and firefighters shot and killed were seen throughout the day and into the evening.
I have the distinct privilege. It's been an emotional day.
Visible pain from city leaders.
It's been a hard day.
Felt at the vigil.
But I have the distinct privilege of working alongside the men and women of our police department and our fire department who choose to come to work every day and risk their lives to the benefit of all of us and our safety.
They put their lives on the line every day.
And I just felt like I needed to be here.
Through tears and hugs, badges have no boundaries in tragedy.
They got a couple tough weeks ahead of them, so hopefully we can all be there for them and they can feel the community caring for them too.
There is an officer who is in the hospital. He and his family also needs your good thoughts. And there is another family that needs your thoughts as well. And that's the family that was in that house.
Let's pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven.
Prayers of hundreds, emphasizing there's no stronger symbol of support than just showing up. I did speak to the Burnsville city manager that told me they have not set up a fund yet, but they are in the process of doing so. This is something that will go towards these families that are impacted. Again, just a very emotional evening, a very gut-wrenching evening, especially for people here in Burnsville. Back to you.
Thank you so much, Morgan. Well, the vigil followed a miles-long procession of law enforcement vehicles escorting the bodies of those first responders from the hospital in Minneapolis to the medical examiner in Minnetonka. The route was lined with people showing support. Heidi Wigdahl has more.
In times of grief, we gather. Even if just to be silent, side by side.
This is one of those things that's hard to put into words.
As strangers waited on an overpass in Edina, the mourning could be felt miles away at HCMC in Minneapolis. From the skyways to the streets. Law enforcement gathered to grieve and honor their fallen comrades, Burnsville police officers Paul Elmstrand and Matthew Ruge, and firefighter paramedic Adam Finseth. Each badge bearing a black band.
It's just tragic that we have to even see this. We shouldn't be experiencing this.
Miles and miles of mourning through Highway 62.
It's a huge deal. We just lost three people, and they have families.
Karen Hartwig could not stop.
Broke my heart. I was going to go help my friend move, and I drove across and I saw this and I went and got her and we came back because we should all be very respectful of what they do every single day.
With heavy hearts, a show of love. A procession spanning nearly 20 miles to the medical examiner's office where family and friends gathered in their grief.
Please know you're not alone and that there is a community that surrounds you with much love and care and prayers and support.
First responders, including members of the Burnsville Fire Department, will stand watch of their fallen brothers at the Hennepin County Medical Examiner's Office in Minnetonka until their funerals. Julie.
That's so powerful. Thank you, Heidi. Tonight, we are learning more about those men behind the badge and their public service outside of their jobs. Sammy Salina is live with more details. Sammy?
Yeah, Julie, we are at the Hennepin County Medical Examiner's Office. And as Heidi pointed out, there are a number of different departments here standing guard to show their respect for those fallen first responders. We know that one of those departments includes Isanti County Sheriff. We're told that Isanti County Sergeant Brandon Oliver started his overnight guard shift just a few minutes ago. He was a mentor to Officer Paul Elmstrand when he was at the Isanti County Law Enforcement Explorers program for teenagers and young adults. Sergeant Oliver says Paul was exceptional even then, but it's clear all three of those killed were dedicated to their community.
Burnsville Police Officer Paul Elmstrand was only 27. Officer Matthew Ruge was also 27. Burnsville firefighter and paramedic Adam Finseth was 40.
We're heartbroken. We are heartbroken.
Police Chief Tanya Schwartz says first responders risk so much on a daily basis.
We pray that they go home to their families. And today, that's not happening.
Officer Paul Elmstrand started as a community service officer and was later promoted.
He was part of the department's mobile command staff, peer team, honor guard, and field training unit.
Matthew Ruge was part of the department's crisis negotiations team and was a physical evidence officer.
I'm not at all surprised that he became a police officer because he was all about doing nice things for people.
Robin Gwaltney used to live near Matthew. He grew close to her family.
When her father was at the end of his life, Matthew came back to spend time with him.
And unfortunately, his life was cut way too short because he was a first-rate person.
Adam Finseth has been a Burnsville firefighter paramedic since 2019.
So the paramedic was part of the team. The SWAT team was called to this incident, and they were in the process of helping resolve that, and they were assisting with the officer, the first one that was injured.
This is the toughest day that the city of Burnsville and our public safety family has ever experienced.
Sergeant Adam Medlicott was also shot and injured. He is expected to survive his injuries. He has been with the police department for 9 years, and in 2020, he was named Burnsville Police Officer of the Year. Back to you, Julie.